Long, long ago in Silla Dynasty, there was a temple in Sarabha, and people went there to pray for their wishes. And the temple gave a festival on a particular time of year, and at the festival, hundreds of thousands of people gathered in the temple garden, and they circled around the pagoda, praying Buddhist chant, "Namo Amitabha, Quan Se Um Bo Sal." They believed the pagoda had special power to grant them their wishes. One late night during the festival, after the crowd all went off to their house, a young man named Kim Hyun was there alone. Then he heard footsteps behind him. He looked back and he saw a beautiful young woman was there praying. She was so beautiful, like lotus flower blooming in the moonlight. So he mesmerized and gazed at her. The young woman stopped and looked at him. Their eyes met. Like a magic, there was love. And night after night, they met at the pagoda and prayed together, and their love deeper and deeper. Then one late night, Kim Hyun escorted her to her house. Her house was deep in the woods. When they arrived at the house, her mother came out and was surprised to see the stranger. And she said to her daughter, "Daughter dear, your brothers will come soon. What will they say? You must hide him quickly." So the young woman handed him and led him to the loft. Kim Hyun was waiting. Soon he heard tiger's footsteps outside the house. Then, three huge tigers bolted into the house and they smelled humans, fresh blood, and they searched here and there. Kim Hyun was terrified. Any minute, he can be the tiger's dinner. He was there in terror. Just then, a thundering voice from heaven shattered the house. The voice said, "You villains, you have killed too many people, my innocent people. I heard every day my people's crying and wailing. I will not forgive you. Tomorrow, one of you shall die." Tigers, they just begged and cried for their lives. Then the young woman said in a stern voice, "Dear brothers, please promise me you are going to leave here right now and go to the deep mountains and never kill another innocent human again." Then the three brothers thanked and swore they would honor their sister's sacrifice, and they bowed and ran off. Kim Hyun came out from the loft and said to the young woman, "Thank you for saving my life." Then the young woman said, "Now you know what I am. I am also a tiger. You can't love a tiger." But Kim Hyun said, "Yes, I do love you. Though you are a tiger, but your good heart is the same as humans. Why must you die? Your brothers should die." But the woman said, My dear, my decision is made. Please promise me. Tomorrow, I will appear in the marketplace and make a big commotion. Then the king will order whoever slays me will get a great reward. It must be you. Promise. 김연 hesitated and even before promise, everything vanished. And 김연 found himself lying on the grass in the clearing. The next morning, Kim heard a huge tiger went rampant through the marketplace in Sarabal. The whole town was panicked. Nobody could kill the ferocious tiger. And the king ordered, whoever kills the tiger will get a great reward. So, Kim Hyun followed the tiger's footsteps into the woods. Then the tiger looked back, and the next moment she became the woman again and said, now, do it now as you promised. Kim Hyun draw his dagger, but he hesitated and asked, is there anything I can do for you, my love? Then the woman said, my love, please build a temple for me and pray for me. I wish I were born as a human in the next life. That's what I had prayed at the temple. So Kim Hyun said, I promise. But he hesitated. He shook. How could he kill his beloved woman? Then the woman snatched the dagger from him and plunged it into her neck. Kim jumped to grab the dagger, but it was too late. The red blood gushed out of the wound. And the woman said, please don't grieve, my love. We will meet in the next life. And pray for me. It was her last word. And he held her and wept. Then the woman became a tiger again. The next minute, people came over and saw a dead tiger and a young man. And soon the king gave him a great reward, and he built a temple, named it Hwonsa. It means tiger's wish temple. You know, the temple already gone long ago. Time may erase the temple, but the beautiful and strange love with a man and a tigress remained for a long time in Korean's heart.